Well, right now, drivers are really feeling the pain at the pump. You know that, as gas prices continue to go higher and higher. Looking at the numbers, the national average has hit its highest point this year, and prices here in Connecticut are creeping up right along with that national average. Amy Parmenter with AAA Greater Hartford joining us now to talk more about the steady rise in prices at the pump. Amy, thanks for joining us.
Stop, right? That's the big question.
Exactly. So let's talk about these prices at the pump. Why are they so much higher than they were about 12 months ago from where we're sitting right now?
Yeah, so the influence in terms of gas prices are the price of crude oil and demand. So at this point, it's really the price of crude oil that is unusually high. It's around $70 a barrel. And even if it's kind of fluctuating a little bit, that's still pretty high. And then you couple that with the demand that we're seeing and with the return to the Great American Road Trip, and that's what's holding gas prices so high. What's unusual here is that we usually see gas prices peak in the first week of June or so, and here we are still seeing gas prices rise as we head into the middle of August.
So, Amy, you're joining us on August 10th, just a few weeks more until back to school starts. Families trying to get their last maybe vacation in, their last road trip somewhere in New England to the beach maybe. What does that mean for gas prices in the coming weeks and months?
You know, we really expect gas prices to stay relatively high through the end of the summer. You know, whether or not they'll start to go down a little bit, maybe just a little bit, but we're talking about 1 or 2 or 3 cents. It probably won't be until September when demand drops off. And we also start to switch over to that less expensive winter blend of gasoline that will actually see the gas prices hopefully drop below that $3 a gallon average.
And one last final point here. You kind of touched on it, but just to be a little bit more specific, in my opinion, the most important question of these three, when are we going to start seeing some relief? When can we start to see gas prices go back to $2.50 or less?
Yeah, well, we keep watching gas prices, and I keep waiting for that peak. But in order to really get them to push down to that, let's say, $2.50 benchmark, that could well be a couple months into the winter. But we should see the turnaround starting in September if we can expect what's typical. So not sure about the word typical these days, but I think we'll really start to see it turn at the end of the summer.
Well, if we don't see that turn, Amy, I know who to call. Amy Parmenter with AAA. Amy, thanks for joining us on the News at 4. We appreciate it.
Thanks, Ben.